Hello friends, my name is Shivam from DevOps Schools and I will help you to enable your learning process in various technologies of DevOps, artificial intelligence, machine learning, big data and many more. This is our initiative to help you by sharing multiple tutorials and videos. And if you want any specific tutorials or any particular topic, then please do comment in the below comment section and I will help you with it. Also, please subscribe to our premium services on YouTube, which will give you access to more content and videos to enhance your knowledge about all these topics. Also, if you want me to help you with regards to the online trainings and classroom sessions by our qualified trainers, then please write me at contact@devopsschool.com. Thank you.
Okay, so let's prove these points which I have taught you. When you create a container, the question is very simple. When you create a container, what happens? Okay, Docker container. This is the stuff. So this is the stuff. So first of all, I said user. Forget about the Docker user. Why you are worrying about the Docker user? Let's worrying about yourself first, because you are also user. You are also user. So let's try to find out who are you. So let me trace it. Look at my screen here, everyone, very carefully. Who am I? So here, this is a temporary process. I'm a bash right now. I'm a bash with the PID number 8560. Okay, 8560, that's cool. But 8560 is a child. You must be a parent. You must be having parent, because without a parent, nothing exists, right? So everyone has their own parent. So let's trace it. 8560. See it here. 8560, the parent is 8558, this one. You were the sudo. Okay, fine. Now let's trace it. 5858, parent is 8537. 8537 come from the 36. 8536. This is, you remember I logged in as a CentOS first time. This is me. I was logged in as a CentOS. After that, what I did? Bash. After that, sudo, and then bin bash. So this is how you evolve yourself. Okay. Now 8536. 8533. See, CentOS, you got the privileges here. SSD. 8533. Parent 8121212. See, 1212 SSHD. This is application. And 1212 belong to one. And who's belong to one? See here, one come from the zero. Simple. This is one PID structure, PID table, PID graph, you can say. So who are you? You are a process in the system, nothing else. So now I said, when you create a container, so you get created one user. So user is also one process. How do I find out? ps-ef grep docker. I have no containers right now running. Oh, is there? So why is not showing? Grep docker or something else. Container D. Let me search container D. Here it is. This is the container. Okay, you create one more container, docker ps-a Docker create Jenkins. Jenkins, that image name which you have used it, and Docker start container ID. So now you see I got the two container. See, so can I grab this container D? See, one container, two container. Now let's see that what is the process ID. 9988 belongs to one, and you one belongs to you. You know that in the host machine. So container itself is a process in the host machine, like you were also process. So one user, it got created, but user behavior is like something else. You should go into that, right? You should go into that. How can you go into that? So guys, here there are two containers right now. Remember, I am the root. You want to get inside that user, that container. So Docker execute interactive way. I'll teach you this command. Don't get lost in the command. Understand the behavior. I'm proving the point. I'm not teaching you the commands right now. I did Docker execute what? This one. In what container? This one. In interactive way. Right now, who are you? Earlier, what you were? Root. Now who are you? So you become is like a switching the users from here to there. You see that so easy. Did you understand that, guys, or not? Guys, are you there?
Yes.
It's just like that. So this is a user. I proved it. Now this user, I said everything is different. Root is sharing the this guy. Root is sharing the host machine, but this user is special user. This user have their own mount. You wanna see that? See here. This is the mount, but not for the host machine. This is dedicated mount. I'll come back, come out, and then I'll show you that. You wanna see that process table? You see? See, they have got their own PID. Mount PID. Network. See here. Everything have gone on. Now, how to come out of it? I came out of this. See here. This is my host machine mount. See that in the host machine, there was a different mount. You see here. And this is the host machine mount. This is the container mount. This is my host machine mount. Both are different. In this PS-EF, you see here. You see your IP address is different. So each user, they mount with a file system of the from the images. They create one network and stuff like that. So let me prove that one by one. So I have two containers right now. From earlier, I run the command from inside. I was inside, but you can run from outside also. How? Exec. What do you want to run? See you. All this process table inside a container. This is a container one. You wanna show you the DF table. See you. Why this and this is matching? This is matching because both has come from the same image, but both are different. You don't see that? Let me show you here. Two containers, Docker execute. First container, ls opt. See, nothing is there. Touch DevOps OPT, right? DevOps school dot txt. Permission denied in the OPT. Because why? Remember why permission denied? Because Jenkins has no permission. Jenkins, this container is running as a Jenkins, has no permission on OPT. So no problem. I will do the TMP. See here. This file I created in the 235 container. You won't be finding in the other container. See the beauty, same file, same image, create two container. And both have a different file system, mount, that's what we were calling mount. Each container, they have their own mount. Here. Now from outside, I'm showing you Docker PS. Do you want to see the container IP address? Docker. From outside, okay. Inspect grep hyphen I IP. See, this is the IP address of container. First one. Second one. This is the second one. See, both the container have got the different IP address. Ping 2, pinging 3, pinging. So beautifully designed, right? Okay. Now, PID, I have shown you. Let me show you one more time. See here, I said PID, they have got their own PID mapping. Always new PID mapping start with the 0. See here, and this is the host machine one. See, this is also start with the 0. So host machine, you got a one PID. Inside a container also you get a PID namespaces. So guys, this is the container and the commands which I run just to you to prove it.
Along with that, you can access our other tutorials such as Docker, Ansible, Jenkins, Terraform, Splunk, AWS, Azure, and various other DevOps related premium tutorials with our channel membership. If you would have any issues with our channel membership, you can drop an email to us at contact@devopschool.com, or you can also unsubscribe from channel membership anytime if you don't want to continue or did not like the video. To get our channel membership, click onto the join button, select the 3D99 plan, and grow your skills immensely.
Please be kind enough to like it, and you can comment any of your doubts and queries. We will reply to them at the earliest.
Thanks for watching.